An IPv4 address is represented with 4 integers separated with dots. Each integer must be between 0 and 255 and must have no leading zeros, unless it's 0 itself. And in today's problem, we have a string of digits s. And because it doesn't have dots, it might represent multiple valid IPv4 addresses. For example, for this one, depending on where we put the dots, we can have the address 10.10.23 or 10.100.23 or 10.10.23 or 10.10.23 or 101.0.23. The task is to write an algorithm that generates all possible valid IPv4 addresses for a given string of integers s. The problem's link is in the description. Try to submit a solution before continuing this video. Practicing is important. Okay, we have this string. We will try to extract all possible IPv4 addresses. As a first integer, the first of the 4, we can decide to take the first digit, 1. But we can also take the 2 first digits to get 10 as a first integer. Or take the first 3 digits to get 101 as a first integer. But we stop at 3 integers because remaining sizes don't respect the condition. Integers made of 4 digits or more are either greater than 255 or have leading zeros. Both are invalid. So for the first integer of our address, we have 3 choices: 1, 10, and 101. And because we want to generate all valid addresses, we decide to explore the case when taking 1, then the case when taking 10, then when taking 101. We want to explore all possibilities because all of them can lead to valid addresses. We deduce that it's going to be a backtracking solution. Let's suppose that we took 1. As a second integer, you may think that we can take 0, 01, and 013. But the last 2 ones are invalid, they have a leading 0, so the only possibility is 0. As a third integer, we can have 1, 13, or 131. All of them are valid. At most 3 possibilities at a time because we're reading the integers when taking 1 digit starting from the actual position, when taking 2, and when taking 3. We just explained why you cannot take more than 3. Let's take 1 for example. As a fourth integer, we can have 3 or 31. 315 is not acceptable because it's above 255. And in both 3 and 31, we didn't reach the end of the string and we have no more remaining integers, so they're not valid addresses. Remember that an address has 4 integers only, so we stop at 4. We backtrack and we take 13. From here we can take 1, 15, or 151 as a last integer. And all of them don't reach the end of the string, all invalid. We backtrack and take 131. From here, we can take 5 or 51. 512 is not acceptable because it's above 255. Both of them don't reach the end. We backtrack and we have no choices left, we backtrack again. No choices left, we backtrack. Taking 1 at the beginning didn't lead to a valid address. Let's try with 10. After it, we can take 1, 13, or 131. By taking 1, we can take 3 or 31, not 315. By taking 3, we can take 1, 15, or 151. But all of them don't reach the end, we backtrack. By taking 31, we can take 5 or 51, not 512. Both of them don't reach the end, we backtrack. No choices left, we backtrack and take 13. From here we can take 1, 15, or 151. By taking 1, as a last integer we can take 5 or 51, not 512. And both of them don't reach the end. We backtrack. Then by taking 15, we can take 1 or 12. There is no third possibility because there aren't enough remaining digits. 1 doesn't reach the end, but 12 is the fourth integer and it reaches the end. So we found a valid IPv4 address. It's 10, 13, 15, 12. But we don't stop here, we want to find all of them. We backtrack and try something else. No choices left, we backtrack. We take 151 now. As a last integer, we have one digit left, it gives one possibility only, 2. And if we take it, we reach the end of the string with 4 integers, so we found another valid address, 10, 13, 151, 2. And the process continues like that until trying all valid moves. At the end, we will have found these 8 valid addresses. How to implement this solution? We have a string s and we need 3 other things. We need I, our actual position in the string. We need address, the array of integers of the address we're building. And addresses, the array of valid addresses, the one that will be returned at the end. In the recursive process, we were stopping when the actual address had 4 integers, because we cannot take more. And in the recursion tree, you can see that even if all leaves had 4 integers, but we took some of them and left some of them. The factor that determines if we take or not take an address is if it reached the end of the string s or not. We can know it by checking if I is equal to length of s. I equal to length of s means that we reached the end. So if I is equal to length of s, we take the actual address. The actual address is represented with an array of 4 integers, while in the output, it must be a string of 4 dot-separated integers. This is why we join elements of the address with a dot, and we add the result to the array of valid addresses. Else, in the recursive case, we have 3 possibilities. Taking 1 digit starting from I, taking 2 digits, and taking 3 digits. And to iterate over possible ends of the next integer, I plus 1, I plus 2, and I plus 3, we use j that goes from I plus 1 to I plus 3 inclusive. Inside the loop, the next potential integer that we will take in our address is the substring from I inclusive to j exclusive. I said potential because we won't necessarily take it, it must be a valid one. To check if it's valid, 3 conditions. It must not exceed the end of s to avoid taking digits more than what is remaining, and it must be between 0 and 255 inclusive, and last thing, it must not have leading zeros unless it's 0. If the condition is respected, we can move forward with that integer. We first add it to the address we're building, then recursively call the function. But this time, we start just after where the integer we took ends in the string s. For example, if we were at index 1 and the next integer was made of the next 2 digits, then in the next call we start at 3. Then for example, if we take 3 digits after it, we start at 6, and so on. This is why in the call arguments, I becomes j. And after we come back from the call, we need to remove the integer we took from the address to try something else. So we just pop, we cancel modifications. That was for the recursive function, but we also need a non-recursive one where we create an array address, an array addresses, and we call the function with I equal to 0 to start from the beginning. This call will fill the array of valid addresses, we return it, that's it. For the time complexity, we're having at most 3 recursive calls where we move by 1, 2, and 3 characters respectively. We obtain this expression. T of n is equal to t of n minus 1 plus t of n minus 2 plus t of n minus 3, which gives an exponential time complexity. But for this particular problem, we have an important thing to consider. We're taking integers of at most 3 digits and we're stopping as soon as we take 4 integers in our address. What does it mean? It means that no matter the length of the string s, we will move forward by at most 12 characters only, 4 integers of 3 digits. 12 is a constant, this is why we get a constant time complexity. We've reached the end of this video, I hope that you understood this backtracking solution. If you want to support the channel, share these videos with other people, and you can also buy one of our algorithms related courses. See you in the next video.